So good afternoon, all of you. Hope you can hear me.
Yes, ma'am. Good afternoon.
Tongue today. So generally, tongue is an essay question. So under these headings, anything can come. So we should study the tongue under introduction, general features, papillae, taste buds, muscles, extrinsic and intrinsic, movements, vasculature, blood supply, nothing but nerve supply, functions and clinical aspects. Okay. So where is the tongue present? It is present inside the oral cavity, isn't it? So this is vestibule or the oral cavity, and when you see the tongue, it has two surfaces. This is dorsum of the tongue and this is ventral aspect. Okay, now what is this section? We have median sagittal section of head and neck region, where you are finding the conchae and meatuses. Okay, so this is nasopharynx area. Okay, lateral wall of the nose, where you are seeing the conchae meatuses. This is nasopharynx. Hard palate, soft palate, you are finding the tongue, and you are finding two arches getting connected to the tongue. Anteriorly you call it as palatoglossal arch, posteriorly we call it as palatopharyngeal arch. In the palatoglossal arch we have palatoglossus muscle, in the palatopharyngeal arch we have palatopharyngeus muscle. Between these two we have the palatine tonsil, and this whole thing is tongue, which is the, this is the tip of the tongue, dorsum and base of the tongue. We are finding few muscles also. So like, because picture is clear, I have helped you to understand this. Okay, now see, coming to the introduction, it is a mass of skeletal muscle or the striated muscle, which is covered with mucous membrane. Okay. Okay. So now coming to the length, it is around 3 inches long and it is situated in the floor of the mouth. It is triangular. It is attached to the mandible and hyoid bone with the help of certain muscles. What are the muscles we have? Genioglossus, hyoglossus. Okay. So it has apex, body and root. Okay. Then. Now coming to the surfaces, what are the surfaces? I said, this is dorsum of the tongue. Below the dorsum, whatever structure is there, that is the ventral aspect. And it has two margins, the right and left lateral margin. Right lateral, left lateral. So this is Vishram Singh's picture. I want everybody to practice this diagram. So for tongue, so this is the oral part of the tongue. Okay, and see, overall, the whole tongue is divided into anterior two-thirds and posterior one-third by means of a V-shaped sulcus, which is sulcus terminalis. In front of the sulcus terminalis, we have the oral part of the tongue. Behind, we have the pharyngeal part of the tongue. So the joining part of the sulcus terminalis is foramen cecum. Downward growth of foramen cecum is helping in the development of which structure, Hansraj? No group answers. Foramen cecum grows downwards. Yesterday only I told you. Some structure is growing during the embryological development. What is that? Hansraj, muted. Imad, what is growing from here?
Thyroid gland.
What is the name of the duct?
Thyroglossal duct.
Very good. Thyroglossal duct. So in front of the sulcus terminalis, we have round papillae. What are these? Circumvallate papillae. Okay. So over the dorsum, if you observe, we have one median furrow. Then on the margins of the tongue, we have fungiform papillae. Throughout the surface of the tongue, we have filiform papillae. And towards the margins of the posterolateral corners, we have foliate papillae. Okay, so this is anterior two-thirds. Coming to the posterior one-third, we have lot of lymphatic tissue. These are all lymphoid, like what do you call them as? Lingual tonsil. Okay, because it is associated with the tongue. Here also we have again the same arches which were coming from the hard palate. The palatoglossal arch, palatopharyngeal arch, in between which we have palatine tonsil. Now when you observe this picture, when you see the posterior most part of the tongue, there you will see the epiglottis, the leaf-shaped elastic cartilage, which is projecting anteriorly. It is connected to the tongue by means of three folds. Okay, the midline fold is called as median glossoepiglottic fold.
Ma'am, I can't see the screen.
Can anyone hear ma'am or see anything?
Nope.
No. All right.